Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Now we know how to create a variable and give it an appropriate name and the naming convention, let's go ahead and play with some variables inside our Django template. If you have been following this course step by step, stage by stage, then we have a Django project. So go ahead and open up in Visual Studio Code your Django project. If you don't have this, then just head back to the first sections where I show you how to install the Django application from a requirements text file, and go ahead and download this base code, which you'll find in the repository for each section. So in this section, you'll find the code or the end code that we're utilizing. So you can go ahead and download that and start up the code. Right, so this is where we pretty much left off. I have started a virtual environment here again, and then I don't have a database. So I will just need to bear with me a second, just double check something. So I will need to go ahead and run Python or /manage.py and then migrate. Okay, so you might not need to do that if you're in a different position than I am. So I do have my database now. Okay, so now we've done that, let's go ahead and go into our new app and let's go into views. So let's take a look again at our Django request response cycle. So far, we have created a new Django app, we built a new URL, we built a new view, and then we also built a new template. And that template was brought into the view to be processed and then returned back to the browser. The important stage there is the fact that the view calls the template, and then the template will then be processed in preparation to then send back to the browser. It may be that we want to gather data from the database and place into the template before we send back to the browser, or it might be that we have some other arbitrary values that we want to send back to the browser. So what we're going to do here is we're going to, from the view, create some variables, and we're going to pass that data over to our template. So when the template is called, that data will be processed, placed onto the template, and then sent back to the user. So this is our function. It's now called home page. Yours, it might be called home. That's no problem at all, as long as it works. Just don't forget to update the URLs in the new app here to the name of your function. Right, so at the moment, we're just returning the template, but let's actually pass some data to that template. So let's build a new variable. So let's call this variable name for no particular reason, and then that's going to represent a string. So Xander, there we go. So that's our variable. We're following the conventions of building a variable. You don't necessarily need to have a space here. I like to have a space between the equals and the actual value. So this is a string. Again, we'll learn more about different types of data types in the next section of the course, but this is a string here. So now we need to pass this data to the actual template so that we can then process or work with that data within the template. So what we need to do here is build a little data structure whereby we have a name value. Okay, so we assign a name value. So let's of course call this name ID. You can call it whatever you like. I'm just calling it ID. And then we need some sort of value. So let's just make sure that's in the singles. So we have some sort of name there. And then we have a value. So what value do we want to pass into this identifier here? Well, we want to pass Xander, the string Xander. So we need to access this data from memory utilizing this identifier, this name. So let's pass that in there. So what we're doing here is we're passing context or data over to the template, or at least we're allowing the template to access this data. And we can access this data here via this ID here, this name ID, this key, if you like. So that might make more sense in a second. So let's go over to our templates. Let's open this up. And inside of our template, we're now going to access this data that's stored in this name variable. So we need to access this data now via this keyword ID. Okay, so that's how we're going to access this data now, via ID. So let's go back into here. Now, if we want to access data, we need the double curlies, and then we just need to reference the key, which is, in this case, ID. So let's go ahead and try and give that a go. Python 3, manage.py, run server. Okay, so I've started the server. I've navigated to the root page where my template is being served, and you can now see it outputs what's stored in the variable. If we wanted to create more variables, we can. So let's go for age equals, and then of course this time we're using an integer, so we don't need the double or single quotes here, it's an integer. Let's go and pass this in now. So let's change this to age, and then we need to reference the age variable. So to give you some background here, this is what I described as a context, which is essentially a dictionary with a key and a value. So a name and a value. So that's being stored in this dictionary here and then sent across or made available in the actual template so we can access the data. So let's just change this to, I didn't want to call it name to begin with because that was confusing, but let's just change this to name and age. Let's go back into here. Hello, name. My age is, and then age. So let's see if we can render that. And there we go. Of course, much of our data that we work with within Django is going to be coming from the database, or else we're going to be handling data from the user's input. Whether the data does come from an input, from a user, or whether it does come from a database, typically we need to retrieve the data and then store that into a variable first before we then perform additional operations, for example, make calculations or process the data in a certain way, or just output it back into the template. We will see a lot more examples as we move through each section of this course.